Did you all know that there are so many ways through which we are opening doors to demons in our life that causes depression, anxiety, and so many other things that God really wants to take us away from? But sometimes we ourselves, we engage into these things knowingly or unknowingly, which is really not only disobedience to God, but also ruining our own life. And in today's video, we'll talk about the dangers of mediums, tarot card reading, horoscopes, and more. Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. This is Ragini. I'm hoping and praying you all are keeping well. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the dangers of using tarot cards or of going to a medium or consulting a medium, necromancy, astrology, all these things which are the things which opens the doors to demons, the whole demonic portal. And I know that a lot of people are gonna say like, don't judge me and all that, and a lot of people will not like this video, and that's totally fine, because Jesus himself, he said that you will be hated for my name's sake. And another thing I want to say is, if you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free, and the truth is only found in Christ and in his word, the Bible. So everything that I speak or say or talk about, it's from the word of God. So if you have your Bibles, please go ahead and open the book of Leviticus chapter 20 verse 6. Now, before you say that that's Old Testament, don't take out the words out of context, I want to let you know that yes, on those specific days or historical background, it referred to Israelites and the people there. That doesn't mean that God in this life, in our new generation, that doesn't mean God accepts these things. Divination is divination. Horoscopes is horoscopes, right? All these things are abomination in the eyes of our Lord. And if you're one of those who loves doing it, then it's time to stop. Because let me start with myself. When I used to go to work, I would start my day first reading my horoscope. And we put our faith in all these people and these things like mediums and tarot cards and all these stars and stuff like that, rather than putting our trust and faith in the one who created us, the only true living God, and his word, the Holy Bible. See, we are not dealing with flesh and blood. The book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12 clearly says that we're not dealing with flesh and blood, but with spiritual realm, demonic realm. So the enemy wants to steal, kill, and destroy. He will let you do everything and anything, but when it comes to reading the Bible, believing in Christ, following Christ, that's when the enemy plays games in your mind and distracts you. But we are aware of his schemes through the word of God, through the blessings and grace of God. So as a believer, it's our duty not only to follow the world, but renew our mind, as the word of God says. So if you have your Bible, please go ahead and open the book of Leviticus chapter 20 verse 6. The title is Molech Worship and Spiritism. And during those times, people in Israelites, all the Israelites used to worship the so-called Molech God. They made their idol and they used to give their first children as sacrifice in the fire to that specific God, which was of course demon, we know that. Verse 6 says, whoever turns to mediums or spirits and prostitutes himself with them, I will turn against that person and cut him off from his people. Consecrate yourselves and be holy, for I am the Lord your God. Keep my statutes and do them. I am the Lord who sets you apart. You are a chosen vessel for the glory and kingdom of God. Why would you want to trust and follow those things which is an abomination in the eyes of the Lord, rather than follow his word? Follow Jesus, our true living God. And there are so many verses, there are so many Bible verses related to divination and necromancy and fortune telling. And these all things are abomination in the eyes of God, because God is spirit. When he spoke to the Samaritan woman, he said that God is spirit, and the true worshiper worships God in the spirit and in the truth. He's not in the idol, he's not in the images, he's not in the graven images, he's not in any so-called man-made traditions or gods. Amen. Let's check another verse from the word of God, and that's from the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18 verse 9 to 14, and the title is Occult Practices versus Prophetic Revelation. When you enter the land the Lord your God is giving you, do not imitate the detestable customs of those nations. No one among you is to sacrifice his son or daughter in fire. Practice divination, telling fortunes, interpret omens, practice sorcery or witchcraft, cast spells, consult medium, a spiritist, or inquire of the dead. Everyone who does these acts is detestable to the Lord. And the Lord your God is driving out the nations before you because of these detestable acts. You must be blameless before the Lord your God. Though these nations you are about to drive out, listen to fortune tellers and diviners. The Lord your God has not permitted you to do this. The scripture is very clear. The Lord your God has not permitted to do this. Talking about the scripture and the context, yes, we know that this specific scripture belonged to those people in that time, but it doesn't mean that God likes us this time, in this generation, in this year, whatever you call it, in this present life. God doesn't like these things even now. It is the word of God. It's clarifying it. We as a believers gotta seek God himself, the true living God, who is the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. Through his word, through his grace, we are saved. Not through our works, not through the works of those people we consult for our fortune. Amen? Our fortune, our life, everything is in the Bible. It's in the Word of God. It's in Christ for what he has done for us. He is the one with open arms inviting you, calling you, showing you the eternal kingdom, eternal life. But we want to run behind all these fake things which are opening doors and portals to demonic realm, which is dragging us to hell. And no matter how good or bad you're feeling about this right now, as a believer, as a child of God, it is my duty to speak the truth according to the word of God. And that's why I say that I am the first one when it comes to astrology and all. I used to believe in it and I used to start my day with it. And I'm sure people out there, they still do it because they don't know these things. And that's why we as believers, we need to show it to them. We got to run the race and preach the truth. Amen. Now, there's a huge difference between astronomy, the study of stars and space. That is the study of stars and space. But astrology is literally the worship of space and stars and moons and lining up and creation and all of that. And it's absolutely demonic. You put your faith and your trust in your stars rather than the word of God, rather than the one who created you, who says that I knew you before I even formed you in your mother's womb. He's the true way and life. He's the only way, truth and life. And the Bible clearly shows everything about the creation to the end of the world. So why do we need to run to these people, these mediums?